Horizon and soul. lady and all the church family here represented, we welcome you. The children have been practicing the play for several months and have been committed to bringing their best selves. The name of the play is New Star. It is a story about the first star that appeared that night as Jesus was born, telling the new star about the story of Jesus' birth and how it came to pass. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. Please remember, we are children that range from 3 years old to 17, so we are not yet perfect. Please allow us to be children as we are praising Him in our program this afternoon. Thank you again.
Thanks, old star. I've been working on my shininess.
Good job. And this is a great night for all of us to live our best.
Why is that?
Because it's Christmas.
Yeah, Christmas. What's that?
You don't know about Christmas? Oh, that's right. You're a brand new star. This is your very first Christmas.
Yeah, is this your first Christmas too?
No. I've seen over 2,000 of them.
Wow, 2,000? Wait, is that a lot?
Well, yes it is. In fact, I am old enough to tell you about the very first Christmas, and I can explain what was just celebrated Christmas even after all these years.
Oh, please. I want to hear all about it.
Okay, to start with, we have to go back before the first Christmas and visit a little place called Nazareth.
Is Nazareth that place in the sky? You know, space?
No, it's a place down on Earth, on that little bitty planet right down there.
You mean the one over by Jupiter?
No, the one further to your right.
Do you mean Pluto? I didn't think that was really a planet.
No, not Pluto. To your right. Your other right.
You mean the blue and green one? The one between Mars and Venus?
That's the one. And look, right over there. That is the town in Adam.
Ooh, look a pretty lady.
That's Mary. She's the virgin. She is blessed to be married to a man named Joseph. Joseph is a carpenter. He is also a righteous man.
What's he doing?
Building something. Carpenters are always building something.
I hope it's a cradle.
I think you're getting ahead of our story.
Who's the other guy? He's all shiny like us.
That's Gabriel. He's an angel. He has come to talk to Mary. Let's listen.
Greetings. You who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One is to be born upon the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, will have a child in the Holy Spirit. And she who is very famous, nothing is impossible with God.
Would be the Son of God.
What did Mary say?
She said yes.
Oh, good. Now what? I like Mary. She seems really nice.
Oh, she is. After the angel left, Mary hurried to visit her cousin Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
When Mary arrived, she found out that things just like the angel told her.
Mary seems really happy to see Elizabeth. Interesting. Elizabeth is going to have a baby in her old age.
Yes. Mary was her own one happy. Elizabeth was happy too. Listen to what she said to Mary.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you have bear. For why am I so favored as the mother of my Lord to come to me?
My soul glorifies, the Lord and my spirit rejoices, for God has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed. Holy is his name.
Mary stayed with Elizabeth for a long visit and then returned home to Nazareth. But by now it was she was going to have a baby. Joseph knew the baby wasn't his, but since Joseph was a righteous man, he decided to put Mary away privately. But after he had considered these things, God sent an angel to speak to him in a dream.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name of Jesus, because he saved his people from his sins.
All of this is done in fulfillment of the ancient prophecies. The virgin will conceive and give birth. To a son. We'll call him Emmanuel. And the name Emmanuel means God with us.
Wow, that's a great name. What did Joseph say when he woke up?
He did exactly what the angel I told him to do.
Okay, so what happened next?
There was drama that went in Rome. And I, Caesar, the Roman ruler, ordered that everyone has to be counted.
Why are you doing this?
Money, taxes. So everyone has to go back to the family's hotel to be counted.
Sort of like a family union?
A little bit, but got the games or the potato salad.
That's too bad. I love potato salad. Did they have peace offerings?
I don't think so.
Then it really wasn't like a reunion at all.
No, in fact, for Mary and Joseph, it was a pretty long and difficult trip, especially since Mary was expecting a baby.
Where'd they have to go?
They went to a little town called Bethlehem.
You mean that little bitty one in the middle of nowhere?
That's the one. It was the birthplace of Joseph's ancestor, King David.
Wait a minute. Is Bethlehem that one they sing about? The one they call Old City of Bethlehem?
Yeah, that's right. Listen, I think you're gonna sing about it. Sing.
Thank you. So I could be with you.
a Savior has been born to me. He is Christ the Lord. This will be the sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and laying in the manger.
Glory to God the highest. On earth, peace to men.
Let's go and find out and see this thing that happened. The Lord has told us about.
Yeah, let's go. I love babies. Most of the time they're really cute. Come on, let's go. Come on.
Thank you.
Pharaoh wanted to destroy him.
That's wonderful. Is that the whole story?
Joyful love, we adore thee. Have a glory, Lord, in the light.
call your sister Nevaeh, pray us in, and I'm going to let her pray us out. Come over here.
Jesus, you have the greater food when you're eating than if you don't. Jesus watching you, and Santa's watching you, so you better be good. And you have to sing the Christmas songs. If you like Christmas, sing the Christmas song and come join my house. If you want to come in my house, amen.
Amen.
The kids have done an awesome job. We have been working with them for months. They have come diligently for months and put up with me for the most part, and all the rest of the youth committee members. And I'm just so honored that you guys did an awesome, look at me. Y'all did an awesome job. We're going to give the children all gifts, but we're not going to do it right now. We're going to have them come out to the vestibule or in the nursery. We're going to give you guys gifts, so don't go anywhere. But one of the things I'd like to do first, as we do things decent and in order, I'd like to extend a gratitude to Pastor Garrett and First Lady. We do have something for you. Do you have it ready? Okay, if you guys could come up, I really appreciate it. Okay. Probably back there fixing something. So I just, this is just a small token of our appreciation for really allowing us to come to the sanctuary, and especially during your Friday meeting times, and eat pizza and run around acting crazy. So here she is. Please come up.